should be told, with a whole lot of heart and a little bit of soul. Well, we're all stuck in dead-end jobs, but the body's at the back, so baby, come on!
Episode of Red Top TV. What's been your favourite thing this term?
The Sandy McKay interview was pretty cool.
I know, it's pretty cool.
I've got that coming up today.
That'll be cool. Did you enjoy the aquarium?
Mm.
We dissected a spiny dog for shark. It's disgusting.
We dissected squid.
Okay. This episode we have a huge lot of interesting stories. Like, first up, the year at Sasa with Taylor.
And then a very important interview with Sandy McKay.
Alicia with this week's sports report, Rippa Rugby, and also some exclusive footage on the Otago Swim Champs.
And Luke and Hamish with this week's U7 report.
And Dylan and Harriet for new week's competition and teacher of the week.
And to finish it off, the birthdays.
Well, let's kickstart up the year at Sasa. Over to you, Taylor.
Was pretty cool. What about you?
Well, they were all pretty cool. First we had to learn the traditional Sasa, which was cool. And then we had to make up and perform our own class Sasa, which was very fun just about.
Yeah, even though I wasn't there.
Now the 40-hour famine story.
And an interview with Miss Brady.
I did a 40-hour famine last year.
Same.
How many race like? $80.
Yeah, I raised $40.
But Kay Rickaby raised like over $1,000 and she won an iPod Nano. She was like one of the most
top
20.
In New Zealand?
Wow, she's got her third book already, her third sponsor book. Oh, anyway, over to you, Luke.
Hi guys, it's Luke with Miss Brady here, learning more about the 40-hour famine. Ms. Brady, for those who don't know, what is the 40-hour famine exactly?
The 40-hour famine is organised by World Vision and it's done in New Zealand to raise money for children in other countries that need it.
Cool. How many people are participating?
So far we've had about 20 people sign up, but I expect to get at least double that.
Cool. How much money do you think we'll raise this year?
Last year we raised about 4,500 we raised last year.
Whoa, okay.
One girl, she raised 1,120 on her own. She
really?
Was one of the top 20 in New Zealand. She got an iPod with it.
Yeah, cool. What does the money go towards?
lots of different projects organised by World Vision. Some of them are education, some wells, some housing, a variety of things that they need.
Awesome. Well, that sounds great, Miss Brady. Thanks for telling us about the 40-hour famine. Thanks for watching. See you next week. Now back to Courtney and Estelle.
I'm so excited about Santa Mackay interview that's coming up next.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
And the GNT drama story. I've never really got to know the GNT drama. I wonder what it's all about. Well, let's check it out. We'll find out.
Did you see that guy? He's so hot.
I know it.
Have I
that guy?
Okay, guys. Who's up for
chucky
bucks?
Every afternoon on Wednesday, the GNT Drama Troupe have been meeting in the Performing Arts Centre, rehearsing the show that they will perform in Term 2. Sandy Mackay and Sylvia Duff have been directing their show, Recycled.
We now have an interview with writer and director Sandy Mackay.
Sandy Mackay, the writer of My Dad's an All Black, Recycled, Congo's Bush, Eureka, and many more. Now, Sandy, did you always want to be a children's author?
I always wanted to be a writer, certainly, but I really only started to write for children when I had my own children, and when I had my own boys who weren't very good. Well, it's not that they weren't very good readers, but they didn't read a lot, so I wanted to write a book for them. But before that, I'd written for about 10 years, I did a lot of freelance writing, which is like writing for newspapers and magazines and things like that. Yeah, so I've written for about 10 years for children.
And what was your favourite author when you were growing up?
When I was growing up, who was my favourite author? I suppose like most people my age, I read a lot of Enid Blyton, the Secret Seven and the Famous Five and those kind of books. We didn't have a lot of New Zealand writers back then, so there weren't many New Zealand writers to be reading. I used to, when I got to my sort of about your girl's age, I started reading Agatha Christie. I like those kind of murder mysteries and things. I read a lot more children's books now probably.
And what's your favourite book that you have written?
My favourite book that I've written. That's a hard one. They're kind of all like, you kind of like them all separately for different reasons. Recycled I really like because it was my first one. And it was, it did really well and it was quite exciting. My Dad the All Black, that one. That's another favourite because that's been a real favourite with children your age. And I suppose the one that I'm writing at the moment is usually either my current favourite or the one I hate. At the moment I'm getting to the end of it and I'm liking it a bit more than I was last week.
Okay, thank you for your time and your interview. Thank you.
You're welcome, thank you.
The show is looking really good and we can't wait to see it at the end of Term 2. The GNT drama looks like it's fun. Now I know what it's about.
Yeah, you're not in it. You're in Hip Hop A.
Yeah, I wish I joined it though. Mm. It looked like heaps of fun with Sandy helping.
Yeah.
Speaking of Sandy, the interview was real cool, eh?
Yeah, she was awesome.
She was nice. Anyway, let's move along to the competitions of Dylan and Harriet.
Thanks, Courtney and Estelle.
We've got a new teacher of the week and a new mystery teacher.
Let's start with the mystery teacher.